Hello, my name is Grant, and I'm studying mechanical engineering at the University of Idaho.
And I'm Rahul, and I'm studying chemical engineering. Today, we are going to learn about how a Newton cradle works. Invented in 1967, the Newton cradle got its name because it demonstrates all three of Newton's law.
After you've completed this activity, you will be able to understand Newton's laws of momentum, the study of forces, and how they interact. You'll know more about how engineers harness these concepts to help them design new machines, like a roller coaster. Let's get started. For this activity, each person or group working together to complete the activity will need the following. First, you'll need 5 standard marbles, 1/2 inch in diameter or larger. These can be found at most crafting stores. Then, you'll need jumbo popsicle sticks. The large popsicles are preferred over normal-sized ones for more stability. These can also be found at crafting stores. Next, you're going to need hot glue for attaching your marbles to your string. You're going to need 5 pieces of string, 8 to 12 inches long. String that does not stretch is perfect. Then, you'll want a ruler. You want to use a ruler to make sure everything lines upright and is exactly the same length. And lastly, you'll want a paper and pencil. Scratch paper can help you keep track of measurements. Once you have all your materials collected, you're ready to begin. First, we will be creating 2 squares for the top and bottom frame of your Newton's cradle. Tape 4 popsicle sticks together, upright and end to end, to create a square. Create 2 of these squares. Take your 2 squares as the top and bottom and form a cube using 4 more popsicle sticks. Along the bottom of the Newton's cradle, glue or tape popsicle sticks across the bottom frame, forming a floor for your cradle. This will take about 6 popsicle sticks to complete. Next, we are going to create the strings that will hold the marbles. Cut 5 equal pieces of string, approximately 8 to 12 inches long, depending on the size of your popsicle sticks. Make sure to use your ruler to check that the strings are even lengths. Attach 1 marble to each string in the center of the string. Using your ruler, mark the center of the string and be as accurate as possible. Use either hot glue or tape to attach the marble to your center. Next, find the center of both sides of your Newton's cradle. Tape one end of the string with the marbles attached along one side, and then tape it to the other side as well. Work your way out, making sure that the marbles are evenly spaced, touching, and sitting at the same height. And with that, your Newton's cradle is complete. When you move a marble on one side, when the marble hits the other, it slows down because of friction and gravity. These outside forces are changing its motion, according to Newton's first law. Newton's second law is demonstrated by how far we lift the marble, changing its initial acceleration. The change in force applied to the marbles in the line will determine how far the marble on the other end will move. If we move 2 marbles, we can see 2 marbles move on the other end. This is Newton's third law, that for every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction.
You can also find more information and real-life examples of how the concept you learn in this video related to the real-life engineering solution.
Don't forget to take a picture of yourself or your group with your completed project and submit it online at uidaho.edu/engineeringthefuture for a chance to win prizes and scholarships. And we'll see you at Expo, April 29th. Go Vandals!